I hope this angle works for you all. Today's video, from this weird angle, is going to be about chainmail. You know, this stuff. About how to make it and the different patterns there are. Is this the standard 4-in-1? So we'll be showing how to do that. Also be showing the 6-in-1 kusari. And also be doing a 4-to-1 version of this. And this little chunky bit right here is because it's triple plied. This definitely helps strengthen it. Now I've got my bucket full of links here. So firstly, we're going to go over the 6-in-1. How do you start it? How do you keep going with it? Only tools you need to work on chainmail, as long as you have the rings, pliers, needle nose, two sets of those. I have this just in case I might need something a little chunkier, but the needle nose generally works pretty fine. For the 6-in-1, now this might be a long video because I'm making chainmail from scratch. I'm not going to make huge segments. But let's see here. 6-in-1, start off with a middle ring and then attach 6 rings to it. Who'd have thunk 6? You're making 6-to-1? But, anyways, it's not going to be the best quality, but it does the job of displaying it. Three, four, and five. And this will be number 6. Okay, so we've got this. Now, what you do from there is each one of these links that are off the center, you'll want to attach another ring. Don't know how well you can see all this. Mail is pretty time consuming, I gotta say, but it's rather fun to work with, honestly. Put you on your side so I can get to it easier. The ants go marching one by one, hurrah, hurrah. Don't ask why that song came to my head. And the last one. Okay. So now you've got an arrangement like this, where you have your middle ring and then a bunch of them hanging off of it. Now, what you do from here is the second rings on each, you attach them. Just one ring across them. Wait. Get in there. Scolding the male does sometimes help make it obey. Get in there. Let's see. Where was I? Okay. Here we go. And that's pretty much it. See, that really is it. Let me zoom in a little more, get a better look on things, what I'm doing down here. Yeah, that's really all it takes to expand it. It's rather simple too. You just find one of your flat links, because the way it'll be, it'll have rings like this and then rings going this way, so you find a flat ring and you do exactly as you did when you started. You attach three in this case, since it already has three on it. You just attach three more. And then on those, grab it. Yeah, these. Before, you just connect these. Then you just connect your new bit to the rest of it in the same exact way. There you go. These are butted rings, of course, not riveted. They're a lot easier to fiddle with. And ta-da! You just kind of expand from there. It really is that simple. The only thing that's difficult is trying to keep track of which ones you have set up to be the flat ones, like that one, and which one you have as the connectors. Let me put it over. It's actually in the camera. You have the flat ones and the connectors. That's the only difficult thing about that. Just trying to keep track of that. Now, I should have 20 rings. Now, they have a 4-in-1 pattern that's much the same. But it's a little more difficult. I'm just going to do a small section of it. This is a pattern I haven't done before, so neat little experimentation. Untangle these rings quick. It's one thing you'll notice a lot if you try to do the chain mill, your rings will get snagged on each other. I'm going to close you first. Three of these 5-ring chains. Whistle while you work. I'm not gonna whistle. And two. You really only need the second pair when you're working on a bigger project. Because with that you can hold the ring that you're wanting to fiddle with and then either open it up or close it with the other set. Yeah, I'm going to need more links. Okay, so we have our 3 chains. Got some more rings. Okay, and all we're going to do to connect them is put one single join between the rows. Excuse me. Okay, there's one portion. This. Connect you and you. And do 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 do. And here you have a section of 4-in-1. As you can see, fairly open. I'm not exactly sure. This was used historically, but I'm not sure why. is against thrusts, as you can see. Clearly a lot of room for it to go through. I mean, sure, you can use smaller gauge and double, triple ply, but still, that's open. There's no protection there. Sure, it'd work against cutting, but against arrows and spears, this is no good. So, there's that section. Lastly, I'm going to be covering what most people think of when they hear the word mail. This stuff. 4-in-1. This is the biggest pain in the ass. Now we're going to do this. There's a couple of ways to do it. I'm going to do it the simplest way. Or one of the simpler ways. At least for me it is. Just make a wee little chain here. Trying to figure out how long I should make this. Okay. So you have your little chain here. What you do is you connect. For each one of these, you add a second link on every other one. Go through there. Good boy. Now here and here. Okay. Not through your friend. Come on now. So you end up with something like this. Next step is you slide two of these forward and you join them. Then you slide this other one forward, like so, and join it. I'm not doing the best job of showing on camera what I'm doing, I admit. End up with something like this. Make sure everything's right on that. Yeah. 4-in-1's European 4-in-1's a pain in the butt. End up with something not like that, and you just keep doing the process, joining here to here, or no, these two here, just going every other row like that, fusing those together, and you can work your way up to something like this. It's a huge pain in the butt, so I'm not going to go much further with this, but that's the gist of making it. Just kind of keep going row by row, adding more, etc. So those are the three styles of chainmail that I'm aware of. The popular pain in the ass, but best coverage, true 4-in-1. And then you have the easiest to make and more efficient, so to speak, cover more area for less rings, 4-in-1. Which is the least effective as armor, but you don't use that many rings, so I guess it's an advantage. Never mind that. Then you have 6-in-1 star, which is pretty easy, gives decent coverage, and it looks nice. I'd say anyone makes chainmail jewelry and stuff like that, you can use this star pattern, and I don't know how 5 would work. I haven't tried it. I might later tonight, but you can use this star pattern for, like, stars. Like, if you're making a chainmail American flag, you could use this sort of pattern. Let me get the bigger one out so you can see it easier. Use this sort of pattern for the stars. I think it'd look nice. Intertwine it with your 4-in-1. And I think it'd be pretty nice, personally. Maybe not the chunky one, but so that's just the basic gist of getting started with chainmail. You just expand upon that, and then if you're making armor with it, you just gotta figure out how to tailor it. You're gonna need a hell of a lot of rings for that, and a hell of a lot of time. But you just make a big old sheet, form it up, fiddled with sleeves, but not. Actually, the armpits are kind of a pain in the ass. I had to fiddle with them a lot to try to get something that stays and have mixed results. But besides that, you just make it the size that you need, just like with clothing, but rings. You know. It's pretty much it.